Graphene is heralded as a wonder material that could completely change our world. Its incredibly flexible, strong, and conductive carbon structure promises to revolutionize energy storage, computing, and technology as we know it. But graphene isn't the only nanocarbon out there with promising applications. There's one in particular that's been capturing scientists' attention for decades, and it has the potential to be even more game-changing than our fan favorite graphene. The only thing is, no one's figured out how to actually make it until now. Currently, scientists know how to create two kinds of nanocarbons, those with positive curvature, like nanotubes and buckyballs, and those with a zero curvature, like graphene. But scientists have theorized that a third group should exist, nanocarbons with negative curvature, also known as Schwarzites. We've made them before on a much larger scale out of polymers and have found them to be remarkably light and strong. Swap these polymers for sheets of carbon molecules, and in theory, you have a Schwarzite, a 3D version of graphene. Its negative curvature creates a structure with an optimized balance of surface area and interior volume. And that's the clincher, because then you'd have the conductivity of graphene arranged elegantly in three dimensions in a way that can store an enormous amount of electrical charge. See, since batteries and supercapacitors require three-dimensional electrodes to store energy, scientists have had to force 2D graphene into 3D structures to make it useful in those applications. But Schwarzites solve that problem because they're already 3D. This could lead to supercapacitors that charge your phone in seconds and batteries that can store more energy and that have longer lifetimes. But all of this rests on scientists being able to make carbon Schwarzites, and that's proven difficult. But we haven't given up, and after decades of searching, new international research led by a team at UC Berkeley has finally cracked the code. To make their Schwarzites, the team used materials called zeolites, which are porous minerals commonly used in laundry detergent. The researchers injected a vapor of carbon molecules into the pores of the zeolite structures and watched as the carbon arranged itself in sheets along the inside of the pores. Then all they had to do was dissolve the zeolite away and voila, a bona fide Schwarzite. So boom, we did it. Time to go make supercapacitors and batteries out of this ish, right? Well, not exactly. This newest research was done on a computer as a simulation. And while it proves that this process could work, scientists will still need to experiment to find the best conditions to actually make it in a lab. And then once they do that, they still need to find a method that's cost-effective before we see it in any commercial applications. But don't get too depressed, as the author of the paper pointed out, that's the same story that was given for graphene 10 years ago. And since then, the cost has come way down, and graphene is starting to make its way onto the commercial stage. So as for our Schwarzite fantasies, maybe it's only a matter of time. One last thing, Schwarzites are named after 19th century German scientist Hermann Schwarz, who studied the negative curvature in soap bubbles. You know, because that's what I like to spend my days doing. Subscribe to Seeker to make sure you never miss a nanocarbon update. And while you're waiting for Schwarzites to take over the world, check out Julian's video here to learn about a different way to improve supercapacitors that involves contact lenses. I'm Marin. Thanks for watching Seeker.